this video, we're going to cover the basics of counting in App Inventor. So we've set up a button to be our event, and then a simple label to show our counter. Right, so I've already set up the basic blocks, right? So every time we click the button, we update the text of the label to be the counter's value. And we also created a variable called counter and initialized it to zero. So counting is used a lot in computer science to iterate or go through several items, right? So we have later, we'll cover lists in different projects, and we could go through item by item in a list, or we could go through loops one by one or multiple steps at a time. So counting allows us to take a variable and count by one or by two, right? And we always start at zero when we're counting, unless we have a good reason not to. All right, so the basic principle of counting involves a math block and updating the variable that we have set up. So we have to get the set block for the variable, and we want to add to set that block, and we want to add some amount, right? In this case, we're just going to add one, so we're going to go one more than some quantity. And if we're updating the counter variable to be one more or maybe two more, right, we want to get the counter variable, right? So this get block will get the value that's currently stored in the variable and add one to it. So right now it's zero, so we take zero plus one and we store that back into counter. So now counter will be one. So on the first button click, we will store one in here and then update our label to be one. On the second button click, we will get our global counter, which now has the value 1 in it, and we'll take 1 and 1, 1 to add 1, and then we will get 2 and store it into our counter and update our label. So this is the basic principle behind counting and updating or accumulating through a variable so that we can count by 1s or 2s or some known quantity, or some unknown calculated quantity.